So with a test, mm-hmm. you've always got the issue of, has it been performed competently?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And that's an issue that can go in both directions, so to speak. I mean, at the moment, in the context of virus testing, our worry will be about tests that have not been performed competently enough. If you look back to the epoch of nuclear missile testing, and here I'm thinking more about testing for accuracy rather than testing of whether the bomb would actually explode. The worry in those days was the tests were being performed too competently. So the Americans used to fire their intercontinental ballistic missiles. In fact, I think they still do fire intercontinental ballistic missiles from Vandenberg Air Force Base on the coast of California to Kwajalein Atoll in the Marshall Islands. But if you imagine you're firing time and time again on the same trajectory, of course, you're going to learn how to tweak stuff to improve your results. So the worry about those tests was that the test firings were too competently performed, and therefore you could not extrapolate to the real use of missiles.
So the problem, I think maybe I misunderstood your last point, because I heard it as the lengths to which people will go to make a test, and perhaps I did not understand, and you were saying instead the lengths to which people will go to wonder, in wondering about whether the test was an appropriate test of real world circumstances. Despite putting a nuclear weapon on a missile and firing it, people could still have their doubts.
They can still have their doubts. Yeah.
Okay.
And I think,
yeah,
at the time, and I worked at this 30 years ago, so at the time, and I think there's possibly still is something to be said for this. At the time, I conjectured that there was a distinctive pattern in the trust or doubt about testing results that I called the certainty trough. And the trough, the people who have, in the sense mathematically, it should be called the uncertainty trough. But I remember Harry Collins, the sociologist of science, persuading me that I better go with John Bunyan, Pilgrim's Progress, and call it the certainty trough rather than the uncertainty trough. Because the problem, at least in relation to nuclear weapons, the things we need to worry about, were people with unfounded certainty that the things would work, that they would be as accurate as the specifications and so on. And what I conjectured was that the certainty trough was at, as it were, medium social distance from the point of the production of knowledge. There were three characteristic positions I conjectured. On the one hand, you have people who are invested in something different, like Curtis LeMay and Barry Goldwater were invested in what at the time was called the manned bomber, the plane with the bombs that would just drop by gravity. And that was, in a certain sense, that interest, so to speak, would inform their skepticism about the results of missile testing of all kinds. Then, at intermediate social distance, there were the people, the senior managers of programs, and so on, the sort of people who might appear in front of Congress, who had pretty high confidence in the characteristics of the technology. And then the most interesting group were those who were very close to the production of knowledge, because of course they're typically familiar with the contingencies of the production of knowledge. I remember one Air Force general talking to me about the difference between Vandenberg, coast of California, temperate climate, and the missile silos in the American Midwest. There was still manual calibration done in those days. Trying to do calibration at minus 20 degrees in Nebraska is very different from trying to calibrate something at plus 20 degrees on the coast of California.
Or plus 38 in the middle of the Nevada desert or Utah or something. Yes.
And so I would kind of expect something of that sort to be the case with testing in the sense of individual testing for the presence of virus, for the presence of antibodies and the like. I would expect those people who are closest to the production of knowledge to have the equivalent of the uncertainty of the general who knows the temperatures are very different in different places and so on.